Countdown initiated. Launch. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Welcome again, ladies and gentlemen, to OEW Ascension. I am Chris Salia. Happy to be back. Happy to have returned. Sorry to have missed the return of so many other people last week. I'm really sad. But, you know, I had stuff to do. IRL, as we all say, real life comes first, always. But right now, we are going to get into it with some excitement. Yes, it seems like the one and only Lex Umaga is on his way to give us a episode of Lex's Complex.
Oh, I love Lex's Complex. This is awesome. Kind of reminds me of Grand Theft Auto Vice City.
Everybody, good morning and welcome to OEW, and I am Lex Umaga here with Lex's Complex. Now, unfortunately, as Cristalia said behind me over there, real life does happen, and unfortunately, Paul is experiencing some real life today. So I decided to treat you all with an exciting episode of Lex's Complex featuring the one and only Lex Umaga. And here I am, ladies and gentlemen. I am here. I am positive. And I am so happy to see all of you guys here in the crowd. Cristalia, that's a very pretty dress that you're wearing today. Luca, you look like a sharp-dressed man. You guys are wonderful. So now, let's get on to business really quick. So last week...
Drop him on his head? Is he okay?
Last week, I was on comms. And Paul had some issues with the way that I was doing my talks. And he demanded that I come out here today for a cesspool. And unfortunately, the cesspool, well, it's not here today. So I'm going to come out and tell my story real quick to you guys. So for the last 3 years, since I've been involved back in SL Wrestling, I have had nothing but negativity in my mind. I have gone out of my way to slander individuals, to destroy people's careers, make up lies about people. And you know what? I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the negativity. I'm tired of the bad talk. And I'm tired about hurting people. The last 2.5 years, I had a monster that I managed, and all he did was hurt people to the point where he got himself hurt. And I'm tired. I am absolutely tired. And I'm here to let you people know that your mind is a powerful thing. When you fill it with positive thoughts, your life will start to change. my life is starting to change. And all I'm doing is thinking positive. I'm doing good for others. And that's what I encourage you, OEW fam. Think positive. Encourage each other. Because Paul and I are the two biggest mouths in SL Wrestling in this organization right here. And what we should be doing is encouraging the OEW roster. Not bringing them down with silliness. We should be encouraging them, offer them an advice, so they could become the next heavyweight champion or women's heavyweight champion. Those days of me trying to destroy people's lives is over. I've turned a new leaf. I am not the man that I was 3 weeks ago, or 2.5 years ago, or 3 years ago. It doesn't matter. I'm here now, and my destination is a positive one. And I am not going to allow my past to dictate where I go in professional wrestling today. And I encourage all of you to do the same. Thank you. Have a great show, everybody.
What is happening to Lex?
Look, here's the thing, right? I know you've been gone for the past couple weeks.
It hasn't been a couple weeks. I missed one day.
One day?
Yeah, all I missed was last Sunday.
So the Sunday before, Lex was normal Lex, right?
Yes, the Sunday before I commentated with Lex.
It seems like when Paul Slater came back, Lex automatically had this epiphany about being a good guy and apologizing to me and apologizing for Duncan Lilith in the river and apologizing for hurting people and apologizing to Monkeen and apologizing and complimenting people. I mean, complimenting Trixie and her cat. He complimented Trixie's cat. You know, out of all things. I don't know how to feel about it because, to be honest with you, any kind of issues I had with Lex was always negative. I mean, come on, I had to beat his ass in a cage match to get him to stop doing what he was doing to me and Lil S. I mean, you know, at the end of the day, yeah, it's good to turn over a new leaf, but is it really him turning over a new leaf?
I don't know, but I don't like it. I'm afraid. I don't like this. I don't understand a nice Lex. I understand a mean Lex, a condescending Lex, a Lex who thinks that he's amazing even when he's not, a Lex who dresses like he shops at the Goodwill. I do not understand this Lex. And what I do not understand, I am afraid of. So, I don't like it, and it scares me.
Well, here comes somebody that everybody will understand, Bill Lawrence, a referee.
Bill, you're late. Are you drunk?
Some things never change.
Well, at least I can count on Bill to be Bill at all times. Oy, oy, oy.
Because the ultimate predator, the female Vray, is here.
Montino says, 2 weeks ago, I was in a freak accident and had to sit out a show while healing up. But now that I'm standing here, I demand a match to prove that I am back to 100% capability so the doctor can clear me.
That's fair.
Whoever in the back dares to stand up against the hottest wrestler, Volcano, come out and face me in the ring. Well, no surprise, it is Alexia who answers this call. All the
time. I can see why. I mean, you know, her dad's freaking crazy, so she might as well take the match too. She's pretty much so apple to 12 crawl from the street, I guess. Cause she's an uptown, get around, anything goes, a girl,
girl, she's a hardcore.
I don't know, what do you think? This is going to be a fast match?
No, of course not. Alexia has her dad's insanity, so I think she will throw her body at Volcano until she's broken and then probably laugh that she's broken. So in the ring right now, of course, we've got Volcano, the Unleashed from Fort Worth, Texas, staying at a height of 5 feet, 8 inches tall, weighing in at 206 pounds. And her opponent is Alexia Camino from Anaheim, California, standing at 5 feet, 4 inches tall, and 143 pounds.
Not bad. Bill is getting ready to let them loose on each other here. And there's the bell.
And Alexia starting with some thigh kicks, it seems, to Volcano. Volcano barely even flinching at the impact of those kicks. Just goes to show you that Volcano is a hard one, and she can definitely take a beating with the best of them. I don't know. Alexia trying to come in, but Volcano making her have a seat there on the mat.
Uh-oh. Governor put a foot here. Yep. Yep. There you go. Yeah. Kick to the thigh.
Ooh. Volcano with that elbow to the knee of Alexia, just working on her leg. If you take out the legs, they can't get up. If they can't get up, well then, basically you have won. That's how it works.
I can understand where Volcano's coming from. She's taking the legs out, and that takes out a good majority of Alexia's high-flying skills for that case.
Look at that knee straight into Alexia.
Volcano is definitely bringing the heat.
How did he kill her for?
1 second.
Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, yes indeed. Volcano just looks like she's playing with her food, and Alexia gives her a drop toe hold, dropping Volcano on the base of her head.
Well, if you give your opponent way too much time, they are always going to capitalize on that. And Volcano gave Alexia too much time to see what's going on.
No doubt. Let's see what she's going to try here. Working the leg. These two are definitely taking it to each other. I noticed that they're both trying to take each other's bases out of one another, so it basically all comes down to who can handle the most pain, and what's going to happen afterwards?
Right now I'm going to put my money on Alexia. I feel like she can take more pain.
We're in Alex Camino, no doubt. Fist drop, and then a nice knee drop on top of Volcano there. I'm going to be honest with you, though. I mean, Alexia, her pain tolerance and her ring prowess, even though they fall into her factor, she need not let Volcano get a breath. Just keep on her. Nice headbutt to the chest there. Oh, and a ring of the eyes right in front of Bill. And Bill has not said a word about it.
Well, we know Bill. You can't trust him. He might be drunk.
What the hell is Alexia doing? Alexia at the corner here throws Volcano into the corner. Working on the knee, around the knee, around the knee, around the rope there. Bill was about to count it. You gotta do a count of five to let that go. Let's go at two. Oh, it starts delivering the fist right to the solar plexus there. And Monkey flips it out of the ring, shooting Volcano halfway across the freaking ring, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. That's some strength, I'll tell you that.
I definitely don't have that kind of strength, but that's why I don't wrestle!
It's never too late to try.
No, thank you! I'm fine. I like the commentary table just fine.
What is Alexia doing, and what is coming up on our screen, and why is she taunting while Volcano's on the ground?
There is no hope for you anymore, because the ultimate predator, the female Vray, is here.
Seems like Volcano might be playing some mind games there.
Definitely.
Alexia distracted by that for a moment, not knowing what to think. Why was Volcano's music already playing? You know what? Volcano's got a whole bag of tricks. Look at that. Definitely capitalizing on the trickery with a nip-up head scissors. And Volcano has Alexia on the mat, and she is back in control of what's going on.
Told you, don't let her gather an offense. Now hits her with the burning lariat.
That's what happens when you get distracted. Volcano proving it that distractions work, but I don't know. It's kind of underhanded if you ask me.
Yeah, that was pretty underhanded. Yep, I can agree with that. Alexia getting up hurt here.
Volcano up on that top rope on that turnbuckle, stalking Alexia, launching herself with a top rope code breaker, and both women down on the mat. But it is going to be Volcano who stands up from that move, and it might be Alexia who is done for.
Kicks out of two. Not bad. That show's got some resilience.
Well, we know who her dad is, so...
Oh! Oh! I don't think Bill saw that. She punched her right in the hot pocket and gave her a jawbreaker.
Oh, well. Got punched in the no-no square.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
And now...
I heard it hurts more for females than it does for males.
It does, because there's a bone right there.
Yeah.
There's a bone. There's a bone right there. So, you know.
Picture with a spear, too. Nice.
Alexia is taking this over. Doesn't seem like she... One, two... only getting a two count, but it looks like Alexia managed to use one of her dad's moves, the Insane Brutality. That's what Alex Camino calls that spear. And Alexia now still working that leg with an elbow drop the same way that Volcano did to her to start. Looks like she's looking to end it with that.
No doubt. If anything proves in this match, it proves that Volcano is actually pretty close to back to 100% and able to hang in a ring for sure. Thank you very much for that tip, Sandwich. Appreciations.
Thanks, Sammy Squirrel. Oh no, her name's Sammy Sausage. I thought it was Sammy Squirrel. Whoops. Huh. My bad. Wow, Alexia is going to town with these elbows. I haven't even seen Volcano stand up yet. And now Alexia looks like she's climbing up these ropes. Volcano is in a lot of pain. Holding on to her stomach, and it is Alexia Camino with a front elbow drop.
Mm.
Volcano is in a world of hurt, a world of hurt right now.
It's starting to get kind of dicey here a little bit, man.
Dicey for a volcano, for sure, but, you know, taunting's never a good thing. You always got to stay on top of your opponent. Let's see if she's going to go for the cover here. Finally, one, two, and Volcano managing the kick out. See, if maybe Alexia had just gone for the cover initially and not bothered with the whole taunting nonsense, she might have had a victory, but now she's got to do even more.
That would have been three, for sure, if she didn't taunt.
Alexia, what did I just tell you? Now you out here? Oh, Lord. Oh, no one is talking to you, Alexa. Jesus.
Damn. When she calls on that trickster god, man, the coyote, it's pretty much a done deal. But Alexia's fighting back here, though. Giving her punches all the way back with that powerbomb set up all the way back to the corner there.
Oh, man!
He buckle bomb right to the corner. Back of Alexia's neck hit that turnbuckle really hard.
Volcano is just dragging her around.
She's limp.
Positioning Alexia wherever she pleases.
She's limp. I mean, she could have pinned her right there to the hand. Oh, here we go. I think she calls this the tarantula lock.
She definitely has it locked in. Alexia trying her best to get out, but she is tapping, and that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Alexia tapped out, so your winner via submission is a Volcano.
Damn.
There is no hope for you anymore, because the ultimate predator, the female Vray, is here.
Just let me know.
So it seems like Volcano has definitely proved that she is back, and she's at 100% and without mercy, getting that submission win over Alexia Camino. Seems now that we have production saying that we have a video coming on. Let's see.
Oh yes. What is this? OEW follow me around with camera day? Yeah, joy. That's all I need. Camera people follow me around. It's not like that doesn't happen every freaking day. So they want me to do some kind of MTV Cribs crap? Or, let's see how you live! Bullshit. So I guess we better start with my parking lot and garage. This right here is a Yoo-Hoo bike. Don't ask me why I have it. I'm rich. I'm allowed to have stuff like this. Yoo-Hoo bikes kick ass. If you don't got one, you ain't living, son. Got a couple sports bikes over here. Got a couple show-up bobbers here. Yeah. Got my three-piece. This right here is my favorite. This is my 2023 Bugatti. I put up in a Bugatti. That's that. Now over here, this is my Hurst. Yes, I be killing bitches nationwide. So I need a Hurst like this because how else am I gonna carry all the ladies? Just saying. Listen. If you don't have one of these in your house, your garage, in real life, you ain't living. Don't mind the guns. It is basically a one-person helicopter. I guess they call it a gyrocopter. Paul Slater should know about gyrocopters. Let's not get into that. Anyway, these kids are all right around right now, I guess. But that's on him. Ask him what he'd do for $20. This is my short-arm limo. This is basically when me and the crew want to go chill. It's from Diamond Motors, which means, you know, everything's crystallized in diamond. Don't ask me how much I spent on it. Just know that it was a large check, and I had to put three or four checks together. A lot of zeros. This limo is when I want to go out with a bunch of people, which 95% of the time is not a bunch of people, because people annoy me. I don't know why, but they do. So it just sits here. Yeah. I did drive this to a show once, but Zach Rage decided to tombstone Cool Nightfire through my hood and break my fucking limo. So now, I don't take limos to shows anymore. Smart idea, right? Alright, let's continue on to the house. This is my statue room. You know, a lot of people have artwork and stuff like that. I collect monster statues. I collect horror-type statues. They got, like, Cthulhu here. There's some kind of bug or whatever. I think this is Pumpkinhead, and I think this is one of the aliens or something. I'm not quite sure, but look at me. Trying to shake his hand, baby. Weird ass. Over here, I have a bunch of submissives being sacrificed. It's genius. Oh, this is aquarium girl that's gonna be put in the house. I don't really do aquariums very much. But I'll tell you one thing right now. That goldfish in there, that goldfish is worth about $60,000 to $70,000. Guarantee it. It's 24 karat gold. If you would cook it and you would shave its scales off, its scales are all 24 karat gold.
Yo, it's the...
So yeah, who else could say they have a full-on fucking gym, and not only a full gym, but a full-ass pool in their second floor? Yep, that's me. Yep. Well, that's us. Look. Look who it is. Look at this man right here. It's Haruto. I'm not going to bother him because he's kind of pissed off right now. He's actually going to be, rest. I'm coming back pretty soon here. And of course, there's Abigail here running the treadmill like always, you know, busting it out, getting things done. Yeah, I got one last thing to show you guys, and then you guys should get the fuck out of my house, son. And this is my office. Yeah, it's probably the biggest room in the house, which is okay. Because there's going to be many more trophies coming along in here. Even Lilith's got her own set of trophies here. In the Rise Woman's title. Mind you, we don't consider certain people women champions. What I did. Lilith was in a battle with Rina Kadoya for that title. And actually, he's one of the only people that beat Rina Kadoya for that title. Which is really saying something. And as I write over here, we got my inaugural FPW Men's Tag Team Championships that I won with Nitro Kicks and Sticks Mayhem. My Intergalactic title, my trophies, my PW Returnee of the Year award. And a whole bunch of other jazz. So, you know, when it comes down to being successful and gathering championships, I'm going to tell you what my coach used to say. And yes, I'm talking about the Omen. My coach used to say, it doesn't matter what title you win, but how much blood you spill from your opponent winning. Because then, you really know how much you earn that championship. I know he's kind of... a sadomasochist, but nobody speaks the truth about a lot of shit. So I'd like to thank everybody from the OEW Universe for coming here. But shit, guts to go now. Because I don't like wearing a suit. And I'm just trying to look important. Not getting to wear a suit every day. Because I'm fucking amazing.
Yeah, the camera guy got pissed off and just, you know, up and left. But that's it.
That was a lot. That was so much.
Hey, listen, they wanted to see everything, so I had to show them everything.
Why do you have an entire aquarium in your house?
There's actually, there's like a lot more fish in there, you know, than there was presently.
You know, I really need to ask the question, are you compensating for a lack of something? Because that's a lot.
Yeah, well, you know, fans are going to talk, but when I offer to bring them into the ring to fight me, they become pussies and all of a sudden can't do anything. So let the fan talk his business, because nobody cares what he has to say. And I'm not compensating for anything. As you can see, I have plenty of ladies there. I have plenty of friends there, and I don't really have to compensate for stuff that I earned. It's not like I'm rich just to be rich. I did movies. I did, you know, wrestling feds, other wrestling feds. I did a lot of other things, but I also give, too. I'm not, you know, against writing a fat check for a charity that I love. Or what I care about. You know, at the end of the day, when you work your ass off, and you have the money to spend lavishly, it's okay to indulge.
Oh, excuse me, not to cut off this arrogance moment, but we are getting word right now that Johnny Angel was found unconscious backstage. Who hit Johnny Angel on the head? Do y'all think it was Panic? Do you think Panic has had enough of Johnny Angel's nonsense and just decided now was the time? Now is the time to strike and prevent him from coming out for his match against Skillix. That's it. Johnny Angel is down for the count backstage, y'all. Down for the count backstage. Your boy is not your boy no more. Your boy is unconscious on the ground. The smelling salts won't even wake him up. It seems like we will not be having this match. That is a goddamn shame. They stole your whole thunder. Somebody just clobbered Johnny Angel in the middle of your explanation of your wealth. That's just a shame. That's a shame. People be doing violent stuff out here.
That's all right. I ain't sweating it.
Well, speaking of people who we have not seen, we have yet to hear from our women's champion, Mama T. Since the night that she won that championship belt back, it's been 2 weeks of just straight silence from an otherwise very, very mouthy, very, very proud Bayou woman. So, after winning the title at Immortality, Mama T threw herself a party in the ring, and upon her second championship win, we thought we were going to get another party, but we haven't even seen a selfie post of her with her reclaimed belt. This morning, though, the OEW Office of Operations released this backstage footage on, X, right? We don't call it Twitter no more. So they released this footage on X moments ago. We haven't seen this footage for ourselves, so please bear with us. We are going to watch now as you watch right along with us.
Phew. I smacked it me good. Ooh. Well, I'm here to get this gear. Still need to wash that. Ooh. This locker opened up next to mine. What is this? Sorry? What is... Mama?
It looks like Nina Prater was backstage and has her hands. Does she steal Mama T's belt?
Oh, Little Miss Prissy and Little Miss Fancy Pants is a freaking title thief. Of course she is. Naturally.
I don't know. She seems a little freaked out by that. I'm not sure she's not being framed. I think somebody might be framing her.
Maybe, but that's probably the first time she held a woman's title in 14 freaking years.
That's disrespectful. Goodness gracious. Wow. So she says that there's a note. Well, Nina said that there was a note and that it just says sorry. And so could that note have come from Mama? Could that be sorry from whoever is, like, framing her? So this timestamp on this video was 48 hours ago. We have barely any context.
My Mama's nowhere to be seen.
Nowhere to be seen. Not even Mama saying that there's, like, an official resignation or anything like that. The Office of Operations not even addressing it publicly. I don't know. This doesn't seem like Mama T. I hope that Nina returned that championship belt to the VP of Operations, T.A.S. Appears, and that's all I can hope for. I don't really know. I mean, Nina has been quiet. She certainly has not said much lately, and we will be following this strange set of events as it unfolds. But at this point, we've just got to move on with the show.
Yep.
Where's Mama T? We don't know. Where's Nina Prater? We don't know. But we'll let you know as soon as we do. But I have word here that Alex Camino is going to be coming out to have a little chit-chat with us. Well, bring on Alex!
Everybody seems to be in a talkative mood today.
I'd like to apologize to all the people for Ariel who didn't get to see their champion in a match this week. But next week I'm going to issue an open challenge to defend my title. And yes, that is all I have to say.
Short, sweet, to the point. Sorry you didn't get to see him as a champion. No, I don't want to laugh. he is a serious champion, an aerial champion. But next week he claims he's going to have a match to defend the title. Well, okay.
Maybe his other title got caught in the rain and he has to make a new one.
I have long suspected that that cardboard title was not safe from the conditions. But, you know, we support everyone, even in their delusions. So, yes. We support...
I even saw Pete the Pizza Hut sign on the other side of that title, but I chose not to say anything.
Either way, Alex Camino considers himself to be the real aerial champion, so we're just going to roll with that. But, ladies and gentlemen, I know I have been waiting for this next insight very much. Let's kick it over to Tank's second anger management therapy session.
Hey, Stanley, baby.
In our last appointment, we were talking about the I had a question that I was going to ask you about in the trash can, and so I wanted to ask not the superstar, but the tank. Did you have any experience where you were ever stuck inside a trash can?
Listen, Tank would answer you right now, but he is hard at work. He's getting that cardio. He's working that heart muscle, them lungs. He has to focus. Every single piece of that core has to be engaged. But listen, everybody's been stuck in a trash can, but I'm telling you right now, Tank Ventura ain't no Rita Repulsa. This ain't no Day of the Dumpster. He ain't breaking out going, after 10,000 years, I'm finally free. No, this is Tank Ventura, and he is a man's man. This man is gonna be the top of everything.
Understand. Well, Mr. Tank, did bullies ever steal your lunch money and steal your lunch? You know, maybe you experienced even more than the trash can and maybe more than just the physical bully. But maybe people stole from you. Did people take things from you, Mr. Tank? Mr. Tank, do you understand?
You know, it's almost insulting every time you say, do you understand? Of course, Tank Ventura understands. You're speaking well English. Like, look.
Oh.
Everybody gets bullied. Everybody has their problems. But the way to fix these problems, and Tank is showing you right now, is to be in the gym. It's sweating. It's making every muscle ache.
Oh, well, perhaps Mr. Stan, I'm sorry, you got me confused because you're speaking for him, but he's speaking and me speaking, and but the other man speaking. Okay. Were you ever forced to defend yourself? Like maybe be alone in an alley or something, and or mommy, daddy come help, or big friend come help. Were you ever a situation where you can't defend yourself, Mr. Tank? Did you understand?
Oh, absolutely. And Tank Ventura probably did have those kind of hardships. I mean, like I said, in our last session, everybody goes through these little building blocks and the problems that we have, the hardships that we face, the tragedies that we go through, they define us, they make us who we are. And if Tank hadn't gone through the bullying, the girls rejecting him, the not getting enough love from the parents, you know, those stereotypical things, then he would not be the mountain of a man. He would not be as strong as he is.
But did the ultimate question comes to me after all of these is that maybe people in your life spoke for you all the time, because even now the big question is, like this overbearing manager, Mr. Superstar, you. So I do not understand why you speak so loudly in other Tank's words. So perhaps we have a separate schedule to deal with his anger management so that he can express to me, because you express, but I'm not sure if he expressed the same sentiment. Does he understand, or do you want to tell me that he understand?
Listen, I'm going to have to cut this short because Tank is on a strict regimen. We got to get from cardio. We got to go hit the weights. We got to do a lot of things. And listen, your questions are rather offensive. Okay, I'm not speaking for him. I'm speaking through him like he's speaking through me. This is almost a religious feeling right here.
Oh, forgive me. I did not know this was a spiritual situation, Mr. Superstar. So, Mr. Superstar, did you want to schedule an appointment with me? Perhaps we can speak about your obsessive need to speak for others in different situations.
Listen, I'm not having any of this. I'm not having any problems. Tank is not having any problems. Yes, he got angry one time, but that guy, that Hunter Brody, he deserved it. He stole that competition, and I will not apologize for the Tank Ventura doing what he needs to do to take it back.
Well, we want to really help him so that he doesn't have to have another outbreak where he punches somebody in the face for just winning an award. So we want to make sure that he gets the proper therapy. Do you understand?
I'm not really sure who's going through anger management here. I'm not really sure Tank is getting anything out of these sessions.
No, it seems like BJ, bold BJ boy, needs to sit his ass on the couch and start talking about how cruel he was to puppies when he was a child or something like that. Because it seems like he's the one that does the whole thing. I mean, he's doing all the talking. I mean, Tank can't get a word in edgewise. Maybe Tank don't want to say anything. Maybe Tank's anger is not necessarily within Tank himself, but with the company that he keeps. Who knows?
I don't know. Tank never speaks, so I have no idea what he thinks. We have no idea what he's feeling. We only know what BJ says. And Mr. BJ, I don't know if I can trust him much anymore, you know,
how would you feel if somebody asked you a question, it was important, and then somebody just spoke up for you? Well, wouldn't that upset you? That would piss me off, I mean, personally, you know?
I mean, I would make sure, though, that I opened up my mouth, but Tank doesn't seem to open up his mouth.
Yeah, no, not at all, so.
No. Well, listen, we are going to hear next from the one woman who never seems to shut up, which is how she managed to get herself a wrestling contract here with OEW. Let's hear it. Take it away, Miss Jenny.
Oh, it's Mr. It's Mrs. Carmax.
Yes, nice. yes.
Promo! Video! Okay, you know what? I'm not even supposed to be here. I'm not a wrestler. I'm just some poor girl who got in a car accident. And I've been trying to work off the damages. And yeah, I know. I need better insurance. That's not the point. The point is, everyone here is crazy. They just hit me and throw me around and slam me and crunch me. I didn't do anything wrong. I don't deserve this. So what if my grandpa and great uncle are a legendary tag team? I am not them. So I've had it. I don't even work here and they keep putting me in matches. Well, I know how to take care of that. I'ma handle this the best way I know how. And you can all find out about it next week. Same mulky time, same mulky channel. Warmest personal regards, Jenny.
Well,
that chick is crazy.
I have been told by backstage that she doesn't even have a wrestling contract here yet. She just comes in here and grabs a paycheck. I don't know what kind of damages she done to that jalopy outside that she has. I don't know if the engine's busted. I don't know. But it must be a lot of money to come in here and get your ass kicked by every female on this roster already. Come on now. You know, take a bus. Take a freaking Uber home. You know, cut your losses. Go get a new car or something like that. I mean, come on.
She clearly wants to drive her own ish. But I'm tired of her. Let's bring back out the wrestling. Daisy Sue first. So making her way to the ring from Vidalia, Georgia, standing at a height of 5'2". She's tall and weighing in at 120 pounds. This is Miss Daisy Sue. And Miss Daisy Sue's opponent.
1, 2, 3, 4.
From Deep River, Ontario, Canada, standing at a height of 5'7" tall, weighing in at 140 pounds, the beautiful genius Karen Winters.
You know, it's like, I call a lot of matches on the SL grid. I wrestle, but you know, it's like it's. I was able to call a lot of Kieran's matches in her original Fed, and the girl's something, man. She's definitely something. Not discrediting Daisy Sue. Daisy Sue's a really good competitor as well. But Kieran Winters is the thinking woman's wrestler. It's like a game of chess in the ring with her. She's always two steps ahead of the competition.
Except she wasn't two steps ahead when Daisy Sue took a steel chair to her, and therefore Kieran lost to Volcano.
It is a grudge, and I hate to say it, but my liaison, my student actually got the blunt of that blow too. She had to go against Volcano 1-on-1 basically. So she's still recovering from that.
Well, the bell rings, and then both of them immediately lock up, but Kieran is body punching Daisy Sue. Poor Daisy. Already getting slammed around. There she goes off the ropes, and Kieran takes her down with a drop toe hold.
I mean, really quick, can we agree to disagree that Volcano's been causing a lot of trouble in this woman's roster so far?
Why are we agreeing to disagree? I'm confused.
Well, I want to know how you feel about the situation. You know, you were here for the summer school, and you saw what happened. And it seems like Volcano has her hands in a lot of people's business.
Wow, that really reminds me of one of the male wrestlers. Let me think about this. Who always has their hand in other people's business and thinks that they are the ultimate ish? But yet, only Prep manages to wrestle against a few different people. Who could that be? Let me think about that.
Oh, it's okay. I know a mirror when I see one, okay? I look at my own mirror, okay?
Alright, well, just so you're aware.
You know, I get it. Just still, you know, it's dangerous work.
Well, if Volcano is taking a page from your book, shouldn't you in fact be supportive of her?
I'm very supportive of Volcano, I'm not gonna lie, you know, she's really tearing it up, but, if she thinks she's gonna get in the ring with Lilith and expect an easy ride, she is sadly mistaken.
Well, right now we've got Daisy and Kieran in the ring, and it doesn't seem like either of them are taking it easy on one another.
Oof. Hard shot.
Wow, look at this headbutt! Kieran just headbutted her!
Definitely some judo going on there. Headbutted her and gave her some bot kicks with a back kick. Climbing the rope now. Daisy getting up. Not standing up completely.
Well, Kieran off of that top rope with a DDT, a flying elbow drop, I'm sorry. But Daisy Sue catches Kieran with a DDT, so unfortunately Kieran was not able to capitalize on that leap from the top turnbuckle. And now it is Miss Daisy Sue's turn to capitalize on the fact that she has Kieran down and out on the mat.
Yeah, that was nasty. That was pretty bad.
Pulling all of the stops out, excuse me. They are really going at each other in quite a clipped pace. There's a clothesline from Daisy Sue on Kieran. But Daisy falling to her knees. She had to take a breath herself. She wasn't she had not quite regained all of her momentum at that point. But look at this now, an elbow drop to the ground from Daisy Sue and then a fist drop. Kieran is on the receiving end of all of Daisy Sue's ire right now.
Oh,
coming out of that corner, matching up, squaring up there against Kieran, but Kieran getting her with a gut kick and then a thigh kick and then a body punch and now an old school punch. Kieran is just using her fists to rack through Daisy Sue's body. And Daisy Sue now fighting back with a series of fury punches. And look at this toe kick doubling Kieran over. We've got a very dominant Daisy Sue. Oh, no!
Man.
No! Kieran! Kieran coming back with this back body drop, and both Kieran and Daisy Sue go out of the ring over the ropes.
That was a nasty landing.
And Bill has begun the count. Kieran is back up on the apron. Daisy Sue is managing to get up, but she is wobbly. Kieran jumping from the top rope, the BME.
Ooh, not good.
That is the shorthand there for the best moonsault ever. Bill yelling at them to get in the ring. As we are at a count of five, Kieran managing to pick up Daisy Sue. And a Daisy Sue getting her bell rung from Kieran. Goodness gracious, Kieran. On the outside of the ring. Both ladies are back in the ring, so the count has been broken up. Daisy Sue is giving it as good as she got it with her own fury punches to Kieran. Now at this point, look at this, a scoop slam from Ms. Daisy Sue on Kieran. I don't think Kieran was prepared for that, as she took the full force of that scoop slam. Didn't even prepare for it. Let's see here. What is she doing next? A suplex reversal. And another DDT. Looks like Kieran's going for the pin here. Count of one, count of two. And Daisy Sue managing to get her shoulder up.
Not yet.
But damage has been done. Both of these ladies are definitely feeling the pain right now. Kieran holds in her face. Daisy Sue barely able to stand up. But Kieran getting picking Daisy Sue up and back into a lockup. But then Kieran just managing to hook kick Daisy Sue. Good Lord. And Kieran picking Daisy Sue back up from under. I'm sorry, from under. From down on the mat. And it's Daisy Sue who manages to chop back at Kieran. Wow! Daisy Sue out of nowhere with some kind of strength just threw Kieran out of the ring. And Kieran ran around, came sliding back in. And Polish hammers the absolute crap out of Daisy Sue.
Definitely quick on her feet, absolutely.
Welcome to the Cow Pot Patty Slam. Oh my god.
supposed to be talking about the bottom of her feet.
I'm not quite sure what she's talking about, but Daisy Sue is quite the competitor. She's clearly got some other gear there. She managing to get Kieran on her back.
Going to the corner, maybe some coast to coast here. Oh, Kieran moves out of the way, and Daisy Sue hits face first right into that turnbuckle.
I know her face is hurting. Look at that, a German suplex from Kieran. And she is getting right up as if there's nothing wrong. Barely breathing heavy, Kieran managing over here on the rope. She's climbing up again. She is setting herself up. We are going to see the goodnight moon from Kieran Winters. And she just nails it. Absolutely nails it.
Man.
Excellent. I don't know why Kieran wouldn't go for a cover right here.
That would be a smart thing to do, honestly.
Seems like she prefers to pick Daisy Sue up. And look at that. That's the Kieran Plex. That is her signature. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, that is it. Your winner via pinfall is Kieran.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was quite an exciting match. It is, in fact, our final match of the, of OEW Ascension. And there was quite a nice little moment there between Daisy and Kieran. You know, I love good sportsmanlike competitors. Daisy welcoming Kieran officially into the OEW. That was nice. So we want to remind you that we are on social media, of course, and if you would like to join us as well, you can become a cop. Wait, what's this?
You know, Ongaji, this was the best idea ever that you came up with. A vacation in Mexico. I'm so glad you thought of it. And I'm glad I took your advice. I definitely needed a vacation. It's well deserved. Oh, but I forgot. This Mexican heat is so hot. Can't you fan a little faster? Like, hurry up. It's hot, and I need some cool air.
Well, it seems like our VP Operations, Tiesa Pierce, is on vacation in Mexico. Whew, okay, well, I mean, you know, to each their own. Apparently now is the time to take a vacation. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you today. Remember to follow us on social media. Join our Discord to hang out with us. And if you want to be part of the action here at OEW, you can join us as a commentator, as a wrestler, as a production person. Heck, you can even be a referee. Please take over from Bill, because Bill is drunk 99% of the time. We welcome anyone and everyone, so please give it a try today. And that's it. We will see you next week. That will be August 20th. So until then, have a fantastic week. And we will see you real, real soon. Bye.
Let's go.